African psychology for me would be psychology for Africa.
African psychology, it is the psychology that is contextualized around what Africans do. There are a lot of issues and there are a lot of dynamics that are happening. And in essence, everything that we do, our cultures, our mixing with other races and so on, has got everything to do with African psychology.
I think African psychology is developing very much topics and is working hard. And I am sure that in the next years, African psychology is going to make a very big development, and that everybody will be wishing to come here with you, like in this wonderful conference.
Basically understanding where we come from, you know, the mindset that we have and the understanding of our history as Africans, and not denying that, you know, so we can broaden our perspective and work as a team within our context as well.
So yeah, African psychology is the science of the behavior of Africans on the African continent.
My understanding is it really focuses on the basics of whatever culture in Africa as blacks. What we are doing, our norms, our values, our differences with the white minority. So African psychology takes us back to our great-great-grand, you know, parents.
Decolonizing the Western traditions of psychology and trying to bring it and Africanize it. That's what I understand by African psychology. So bring it back to Africa and an understanding of how we see psychology in the continent, in our countries.
My view is that African psychology is a multi-system study of the African people in terms of behavior, thought processes, and other aspects of our life. African psychology should be very critical for us to understand the way we live, the way we organize, our living experiences, or our lived experiences. We cannot incorporate psychology in totality when we don't include African psychology. We have to learn on our behavior, our people. We have to try to understand the mentality. Without understanding the concept of our lived experiences, we cannot do much understanding this.
African psychology, you must begin with some of the assumptions that is of Africa about what psychology is and who human beings are. So for instance, one of the things I had interpreted and then constructed my practice around that is what the self is. And for me, in an African context, the self is relational, the self is connected, the self is continuous with everything around it, nature, other people, etc. So I then started to practice a psychology that is consistent with that notion of a self.
Understanding of African psychology would be a psychology that responds to the real needs of the African people, a psychology that is based on African philosophies, but also a psychology that does not discard the Western understanding or the Western or Eurocentric kind of psychology, because there needs to be a combination of the two, because we can't discard the knowledge that we already have because we are identifying ourselves or we are taking our space. So I would say there's a need therefore to come up with an understanding that is combining both what we have and what we have but have not been recognizing, which is the African way of doing things. And yes, of course, we have to respond to the needs of our community. Our trainings need to speak to the needs of the community. And that means we need to relook the curriculum and we need to relook the training strategies, the selection of training, so that we produce African-centered psychologists.